If you don't know me yet, my name is Sid. But what you would already know is that Apple updated its iPhone lineup yesterday by introducing iPhone 7 and iPhone 7 Plus to it. And I was pretty excited about the two new devices launching, more so because of the repercussions they'll have on other phones. I'll talk about the repercussions later in this video, but right now, let me tell you my opinions about the two new devices as the iPhone 7 comes to India on October 7th. So let's first start by talking about the design and display of the new iPhones, because for me, they are the most disappointing features of the iPhone 7. Starting with the design first, the phone shares a design language with the iPhone 6s, which in turn had the same design as the iPhone 6, which means that you get a two-year-old design on this device. And I personally am not a great fan of the iPhone 6's design. I think it's a bit too rounded, it's a bit too slippery, it's a bit too curved, but those are my personal opinions. Apart from that, there are two major changes in the design. Number one, the antenna band from the back are gone, which makes the phone look a bit more classy. And number two, the home button now is more tactile. There's another change here that the phone now comes in two other color options. You have a black one and you have a jet black one, apart from gold, rose gold and silver. However, the black one looks a lot like the iPhone 6s space gray version. And the jet black one uses a gloss finish at the back, which according to Apple is prone to scratches. But one major change in the designing of the iPhone this year, one welcome change rather, is that the new iPhones are both dust and waterproof. It took Apple 9 years to do that on an iPhone, and it's a welcome change. But the displays do disappoint. You have the same display from the iPhone 6 in terms of size and resolution. And even though Apple has bettered the viewing experience by adding 25% of more brightness, having a better color gamma and all those other features, you would expect at least a full HD display on the iPhone 7, which you did not get. And now I want to talk about the audio of the new iPhones. And the reason I'm keeping this section separate is because Apple has done quite a lot of things this year in this field. Starting with the speakers. So the new iPhones will come with dual stereo speakers, one at the top and the other at the bottom. And the audio output has increased from the past, which of course is appreciated. But what might not be so much appreciated is that the headphone jack is now gone, as expected. But Apple is bundling earpods with a lightning connector at the end, and they gave you a couple of reasons in the event why they're not including the headphone jack, including waste of space and giving you better audio quality. However, the issue is I cannot use the new earpods when my phone is on charge or say it's connected to a computer. And to solve that issue, Apple has introduced wireless earpods called AirPods, which use the W1 switch to connect to your devices. And they come with an attractive carry case, which also act as a charger and give you around 24 hours of battery life throughout the day. However, at a price tag of 15,400 in India, I believe it's too expensive a price to pay for not including the headphone jack. Coming to cameras now, Apple claims that Apple iPhone 7 will have the best smartphone camera in the world. And if you look at the tech that comes with it, it may very well be true. The phone's camera is still 12 megapixel, however, they now have a bigger aperture, a 1.8F aperture. Apart from that, the optical image stabilization function is now available on both the iPhone 7 and iPhone 7 Plus. Earlier, it was only restricted to the Plus variants. Lastly, the ISP, the image sensing processor, has been improved a lot. And in fact, the cameras on iPhone 7 Plus are way better than the ones on iPhone 7 because it has two lenses, two 12 megapixel rear cameras. The second one is for telephoto. It gives you exceptional zoom capabilities, including 2x of optical zoom and 10x of digital zoom. And the images that we saw from the Apple event, the result was phenomenal. Apart from that, there is also an in-depth view of wheel feature, which is an effect which would be available for the iPhone 7 Plus later this year. And apart from all this tech mumbo jumbo, the LED flashlight has been improved. It is now a quad LED two-tone flash. And the front camera has also been upgraded. It is now 7 megapixels, though the resolution is still HD. Coming to performance now, there is a big change here. The new iPhones use Apple's A10 Fusion processor, which gives you twice the amount of speed than the iPhone 6 and uses 1/5 of the power it used, which means that the new processor is both powerful and power efficient. In fact, Apple claims that you can get up to 2 hours more battery on the iPhone 7 than iPhone 6s and up to 1 hour more battery on the iPhone 7 Plus than the 6s Plus with the new chip. Also, with 3 times better graphics than the iPhone 6 on board, Apple claims that this is the most powerful CPU ever used on a smartphone. And of course, the phone comes with the latest iOS 10 on board. So now that you know all about the iPhones, let me give you my opinions on it. Personally, I have mixed feelings about the new iPhone 7. I never really liked the design of the iPhone 6. It is too rounded, it's too curved, it is too slippery, and the home button has been there forever now. And the problem is iPhone 7 uses the same design as the iPhone 6, which does not, and getting a paint job, painting it black does not help. Nor does getting a glossy back help, because it just makes it more fragile in fact. But design aside, the phone seems to be a powerhouse in terms of specifications. If Apple can kick ass with a dual core processor, I do not know what all it can kick with a quad core processor on board. Apple generally lives up to its claim. And talking about the cameras, I finally believe that Galaxy S7 would have a competitor now. Even though Galaxy S7 has a better aperture, it has a 1.7 aperture and it comes with dual pixel technology on board, Apple has proven in the past that it knows a thing or two about making smartphone cameras. The iPhone 7 Plus's camera, with that level of zoom and detail, it is more a threat to the DSLRs, not to the smartphones. It's in a different league altogether. However, the lack of a headphone jack is surely a bummer. I'm not a very big fan of connectors and dongles, because I keep on losing them. And I would not spend 15,400 rupees to buy Apple AirPods. They're just too expensive. So that means that I either need to use Bluetooth headphones, which by the way have quality issues, or I would never be able to listen to music while my iPhone is on charge or connected to a computer. But remember the repercussions I talked about in this video, at the starting of this video? Well, here it is. While Apple did not increase the price of the iPhones from the past, they have doubled up the storage, which means 32 gigs is now your base model and 64 GB is now gone. But what they have done simultaneously is that they have introduced a new base model for the iPhone 6S and 6S Plus. They now start at 32 gigs. And at $550, I think I would buy that one. And you should too if you have some relative coming from the USA, because once it hits the Indian market, the prices would soar up. The Apple iPhone 7 pre-orders begin on 9th of September. It goes on sale a week after that on 16th of September. And it would be hitting more countries in the month of September, but India is not a part of them. In India, the phone comes on 7th of October, and the pricing is starts for 60,000 rupees for the 32 gig variants of iPhone 7 Black, Gold, Rose Gold, and Silver. The Jet Black does not have a 32 gig variant. It just starts with 128 GB, which means the only phone that would distinguish it from the iPhone 6S, you'll have to pay a better price for that. Whenever the phone comes to India, I would be reviewing it, so you might want to stay tuned to our channel, and the best way to stay tuned is hitting that subscribe button. Also, give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends. My name is Sid, keep seeing me. Ciao.